Hey everybody, Jem Schofield here with the C47 and another episode of Gearbox. So, I didn't want to do the typical I'm then laying on the ground being Vinny for today's episode. The weather here in Cape Cod, first day it was sucking, and then the second day was a chance of sucking with actual sucking, and then tomorrow it looks like it's going to basically be 100% sucking. And then maybe on Thursday a chance of sucking. So it's pretty sucky weather, but here I am doing another Gearbox. Okay, so here's the deal. I'm looking at my phone because I want to show you guys something. So this little setup right here is just to show you and talk about a couple of different things. It's not perfect, but it will allow me to talk about a couple of things. The first one is that I've got that little Alzo LED 790 there, and being held up by a kind of rigged two-part nasty clamp is a little tiny silk, a little pop open one, you know, those ones that collapse from PhotoFlex, or this actually happens to be from a Dado light kit. And that's just helping diffuse that light. Now, the lens that I have on here is the old 55 millimeter Zuiko OM lens from Olympus. And the thing with that lens is it's got a really funky old coating on it. So when you put the color temperature, and I'm looking at my monitor because I was checking it earlier, when you dial in your color temperature on your camera, it's not always going to match up with your light source. It's not going to be as accurate as something like a Zeiss or a Canon lens. So it might be a good idea to hold something up like this. Obviously, some people will hold up an 18% gray as a reference. But at least this way, when you hold something up white in that lighting, you can dial in and actually find something that gets pretty close to white. Now, I have the Rode video mic on here, and people have been asking me, can I actually use that mic as a main mic using single system? And the answer is you can, but you have to be really, really careful about when you do that. I use it almost 100% of the time for reference miking. In this situation, I have a 55 on here. I generally want to get pretty close up to the lens, and I am pretty close actually to the camera. And if I want to see a little bit more of the person, then I probably use something like a 35 millimeter focal length. So in this situation, I'm getting in a little tighter so that I'm a little bit closer to the mic. And you can see I've sort of rigged this so that it's not sitting on the top of the camera, so that the mic is basically going above my head and not picking up that audio. Of course, I have the little Marshall monitor there for reference. I'm covering or blocking my audio here by putting this iPhone over there. But I think you guys get the idea that you've just got to think about this stuff. A diffuser for an LED light makes a big difference. Placement of a little Rode video mic, if you're going to be doing something like this, is really important. And while this is not ideal, let me turn this off, it at least is something. Also, having a relatively dead room will help you tremendously. This is not actually a tremendously dead room, so we're probably going to hear a lot of stuff going on. And then also remember to bring a reflector. I know I've talked about them a lot, but just being able to, you know, take another stand with a clamp and being able to adjust or have control over your fill by putting that there allows you to basically, with a couple of light stands, a few clamps, I love the nasty clamps because they're so versatile, and, you know, your camera, a few lenses, even a decent, you know, zoom lens like a 24 to 70 will allow you to do so much stuff. But here's the deal. You see how everything is really soft behind me? That's because I have a really fast lens. And there's a huge difference between having an f4 lens and having an f2.8. In fact, twice as much light is being let into that camera. So your depth of field is that much more shallow when you go from an f4 to a 2.8. Right now I'm at a 2, so I'm even more wide open. And then this particular lens goes to an f1.2. So we're talking about even more than twice as much light being let in than an f2.8, which is considered a fast lens. So when we're talking about fast lenses, one of the things that it's really giving us is that shallow depth of field. And when you're in a small space like this and you need to do a quick setup, having a couple of fast lenses inside your bag is going to make a big difference. Get a fast 50 millimeter lens. It will help you tremendously. Get a fast 85 and you'll be able to shoot between those two lenses pretty much anything that you want to shoot. Of course, there's a lot of versatility, especially for interviews, having a zoom lens, but I'm just babbling now. By the way, I'm going to send you guys to a link, looking on the monitor, a link of a very cool announcement from Canon. It's a new APS-H sensor. That's the same size sensor that's in the 1D Mark IV. And what's really interesting about this, and you'll read about it, is that Canon is obviously thinking about video when you read the press release. So we've got a ginormous sensor with tons of resolution, and they're thinking about using just a portion of that, somewhere on that chip, on that sensor, to use for high definition 1920 by 1080 video. But the possibilities are much larger than that, and I think that what we're looking at is a situation where Canon seems to be getting it. Check it out. Tell me what you think. I actually am really liking that people have come back to life recently, and I'm starting to get more comments and questions and suggestions. And I'll see you guys next time on Gearbox.